Keith One Time Thurman, that's the fighter I'm going to be talking about in this next video. You know, you'll listen to a lot of YouTube channels and you'll hear, you know that fighters are favored on some channels. Right on this channel right now, you're going to hear an individual that has interviewed Keith Thurman on a number of occasions, and I feel that I can separate myself from, you know, the fact that I have done a lot of interviews with Keith, and you would, it's very easy to become very biased in your opinion. I'm going to try and separate my opinion from what I'm seeing. I did an interview recently with George Foreman III. For those who don't know who George Foreman III is, he is the son of George Foreman, the former heavyweight champion of the world, who fought with Muhammad Ali famously in the Rumble in the Jungle, and also fought Joe Frazier, and in one fight lifted Frazier off his feet with an uppercut, knocked him down about five times. Just one of the biggest punches in heavyweight history. But anyway, I spoke to George Foreman III, and he mentioned Keith Thurman. We talked about Keith Thurman. An interview talked and said that he felt Keith Thurman could be the next pound-for-pound best fighter in the world if he's managed correctly. And he doesn't believe that Keith Thurman's career has been managed correctly. In fact, before the Guerrero fight was announced, George Foreman III said he believed that Keith Thurman should fight on a lot more undercard fights for the next 2 to 3 years, build up his resume, continue beating guys, and then in 2 or 3 years' time, when Pacquiao and Mayweather have left the scene, then he should make his march to become the world's number one fighter, because he believes he's very talented. However, that's not the case, and he fears for Keith Thurman's career that it won't be the career that it should be, and he's being rushed. No sooner does he say this than, like, 2 weeks later on, Keith Thurman is now going to be fighting Robert Guerrero. That fight is not a foregone conclusion, because everyone's saying, yeah, Keith Thurman's a big puncher. Yeah, Keith Thurman's got skill. Yeah, Keith Thurman, KOs for life. And yes, I am a Keith Thurman fan, but Robert Guerrero will be the best fighter that Keith Thurman would have fought in his career up to this point. Now, you have to start to ask yourself the question. Bundu was a seasoned pro, and Keith dropped him in the first round, but couldn't finish him off. Couldn't finish him off because Bundu was caught cold. Couldn't finish him off because Bundu takes a great shot. Or couldn't finish him off because at a certain level, Keith Thurman's punch power isn't as effective. These are questions we really haven't got the answers to yet. We know Zavich went 12 rounds with Thurman, and Thurman couldn't get him out of there. We know that now Bundu went 12 rounds with Thurman, and, you know, again, Thurman can get him out of there. Now he's going to fight Robert Guerrero, who has never been stopped, has got good knockout power, has fought the best in terms of Floyd Mayweather, has been in the ring with Floyd Mayweather, has also fought Berto, has a very good chin. But the one thing about Robert Guerrero, which we saw in the Floyd Mayweather fight, he cannot change in mid-fight in terms of game plan. And Floyd Mayweather switched up on him in the middle of the fight. And once Floyd Mayweather started popping him with the right hand, Guerrero had no answer to that. We do know that Keith Thurman can switch in the middle of a fight. He can switch from puncher to boxer. We know that he can move around the ring in and out from side to side. He's got lateral movement. We do know that. We do know that Keith likes to throw punches from wide angles. We also know that Robert Guerrero punches straight down the pipe as opposed to Keith coming wide. So there are issues there. Also, if you look at Keith Thurman in fights, you look at the Bundu fight, he does bruise very easily and could be liable to be getting cut. The other thing we don't really know about is Keith Thurman's chin. Yes, he has been against guys that can punch. We look at the Chavez fight, but Keith himself has said that there's nobody really in the welterweight division he believes that could knock him out. In the point, in the fact they say that the guys that he's fighting are not one punch, devastating one punch knockout artists, which means he thinks he can leave his chin out to dry, which you've heard me say in a number of occasions really is dangerous, which makes him the exciting fighter that he is. So really, the fight against Robert Guerrero, oh yeah, Keith's going to go out there and blast him over in a couple of rounds. I'm not so sure. I think this fight is going to be a very exciting fight. There's something between Robert Guerrero and Keith Thurman. I'm not sure what it is, because Keith's been wanting this fight for a while. He's been saying that Robert's been ducking him. Robert's now taking the fight on. The question is, did Robert come to the table with open arms wanting this fight? Or did he get his hand get forced into this fight? I don't know. I'll try and get to the bottom of that. But we know we've got a fight with Robert Guerrero and Keith Thurman. The only thing Keith Thurman can do in this fight that will impress the public is to knock Robert Guerrero out. He's got to lay him out. He's got to literally knock him out. Because other than that, people will say, well, Floyd Mayweather beat him. They always beat him before. So what are you doing? You're going over all ground. So Keith Thurman has to go and fight a guy that's never been beaten before, i.e. he's got to go across, come to the UK and beat Kell Brook, knock Kell Brook out. Or he's got to go and beat Floyd Mayweather and knock Floyd Mayweather out. But then if he knocks Floyd Mayweather out, well, people say, well, Floyd's come to the end of his career and well, he was cherry picking. And so, you know, Keith Thurman, for all it's worth, his career so far and all the knockouts for life and all the rest of it, he really... it's in a no-win situation. He just has to fight to please himself and please the fans, the people that support him. So he's starting to get a lot of hate because of the fact that he's outspoken, speaks his mind, very charismatic. And people don't still like that in boxing. People don't seem to like people who've got an opinion, articulate, can express themselves. I like Keith Thurman. The guy can express themselves. He's, I think he's a quality operator. But he needs that marquee fight. He needs that fight that we see him really have to dig deep. He needs that fight where he has to pull out all the stops. And I have a funny feeling this Guerrero fight could be more dangerous than people letting on for. Just for the fact that Keith Thurman likes to load up on his shots and he comes from the wide angles. That's the thing. And, you know, later on in the fight where Guerrero's punching quite straight, workhorse-like, punching straight, could he catch Keith in the exchanges? That's the thing. Keith mentioned already in an interview he did in that he said that he's going to find out whether he's going to sit in the pocket, whether which means stand and trade with Guerrero, or he's going to be on the outside. I'm not so sure Keith's going to get the comfortability zone where he's able to pick and choose, because he's at a level now where he's fighting the best fighters in the world. And I do think Robert Guerrero's up there in the top five. So we'll see. No predictions in this one, but these are just my thoughts. I also agree with George Foreman III. I believe that Keith Thurman could have, you know, taken some undercard fights. But in this day and age of boxing where people want fast results, his career has been rushed somewhat. So, and if you make statements like chaos for life and I'm going to knock this person out and this person's running from me, you're putting yourself on the line. And when you put yourself on the line, people want you to deliver. And when you don't deliver or you come up short, people get on your back. And Keith has now put himself in a slight position here where, you know, he's saying he's going to try and be the first man to knock out Robert Guerrero. Again, yes, as much as that sounds great, and, you know, I'd be a liar if I didn't say that's great coming out of Keith Thurman's mouth. If he doesn't knock Robert Guerrero out, then, you know, the pressure is going to be on his back even more. And he said himself that if he doesn't knock Robert Guerrero out, that's going to put more pressure on him. So we'll see how this all ends up. But, you know, I'm not one of these guys that are going to sit and tell you that Keith Thurman's indestructible, he's unbeatable. And I'm not going to say that. You know, every fighter has his limitations. It's just been the fighter who's in there and the night who can capitalize it. So I just think that if you start banking on your punching power, expecting your punching power to get you out of trouble against someone like Robert Guerrero, who, like I said, is pretty orthodox, punches straight down the line. He doesn't do anything spectacular, Guerrero, but what he does pretty good. And Mayweather is a masterclass, you know. Keith brings speed, power, movement, a great boxing IQ in the ring. But I wonder if Guerrero could grind Keith down. If you can take Keith's power, like I said with the Bundu fight, if you can take Keith's power, close the range down, and start landing on Keith's chin, what can happen? He was rocked by, what's the gentleman's name again? Soto Carras. So, it's interesting. Let me know what you guys think. I think this is going to be a cracker. I'm out.